we're buying ads on billboards and TVs all over the place, why shouldn't retail be a media channel? And so I turned to my mom and I asked her that question that I realized looking back would change my life, and that was, you can shop for a living. So I'm here to tell you about how I came up with my career to shop for a living. So thank you again for having me. The concept of story is this, is we have the point of view of a magazine, we change like a gallery, and we sell things like a store. And by change like a gallery, I mean everything, the design, the inventory, all of it. So in creating our identity, you know, how do you do this, right? How do you create a brand that's always changing but constant, right? I signed a 10-year lease, I'm not going anywhere. So we worked with the amazing design team, Stefan Sagmeister and Jessica Walsh, and the idea was story. So you walk into our Living magazine, and this is our wellness story with over 400 plants on a wall. This is our Making Things story, our Home for the Holidays story. All in all, we've done 14 different stories. So what I want to talk to you about today is this concept called retail media that I stumbled upon. This idea that if we're buying ads on billboards and TVs all over the place, why shouldn't retail be a media channel? This is the cover of InStyle's color issue, and this is the cover of our color issue. And so if we take the magazine analogy, magazines tell stories through editorial, through writing articles and taking pictures. We tell stories by curating merchandise and having events. And then we have a publishing side of the business. It's sponsorship. Brands pay us a lot of money to sponsor our different stories. So I'll spend some time talking about that for a few minutes. So this is, you open up InStyle's magazine, you see editorial, a letter from the editor adjacent to a nice ad from Clinique. And in our color story, you see Benjamin Moore adjacent to the cover of our color issue. And what's interesting about this is a couple things, right? So I don't just have a second revenue stream, but I have a brand that's also my storyteller. Benjamin Moore knows a lot more about color than Rachel Shechtman or the story team. So I always say we know a little about a lot of things, and then we bring in experts to kind of help us tell stories. But what I think is really important is if you're gonna have technology in a physical experience, have it be something that I can't do at home. If there's a laptop with your website in a store and I have the product right in front of me, I can do that at home. So we worked with this small company called General Electric, and we partnered with Architizer, which is the largest online international community of architects, and we had a competition for makers from across the country and around the world to design our store windows. And this was the byproduct. And what they had to do is they had to design store windows with the materials and the technology that would later be in our store. And this is what happened. It was called Shadow Puppet. So when you stood in front of the windows and moved, the pellets moved against you. And within that store, there were laser cutters and 3D printers, and those were all the machines that made that. And really what this all leads to is, right, it's not your typical retail store. And so we've had all these online business models. You heard from Neil earlier about Warby Parker, and there's crowdsourcing, and there's all this stuff that we now, you know, expect cars to come in 2 seconds thanks to Uber. And yet these physical stores that exist for 100 plus years aren't being judged on anything different than sales per square foot. So I think it's time to reinvent how we look at that, and if you look at how you structure something, it will also end up benefiting the byproduct. So what do I mean by experience per square foot? If we talk about this Making Things story that we worked with General Electric on, 75% of our square footage was pure experience. So there was the CNC mill and the injection molding machines and the laser cutters, and you could make sunglasses, and you could come to lectures, and you could hear whatever you wanted. So how do we look at what we're doing and know if we're doing a good job and learn things from what we're doing? So we're used to web trends and other reports and analytics like this for online. And this is showing not just a time lapse of our store, but what you're gonna start to see is color appear. And what that actually is heat mapping. So our entire store is heat mapped. So what that means is depending on where you move in the space and how long you are there, it is recording that data. Green spaces are where people are spending more time, less time. Red is where it's more dense. And why is it interesting? It's interesting for us for a couple reasons. Because we're always moving our fixtures. So it's helpful for us to know how people are moving in this space. And so if we change a layout or do something else, we can see how someone's experiencing the store. But then we can take it a step further and wonder, is it how people are moving in this space, or is it the merchandise? Is it the book on that table that's so awesome that everyone's standing there looking at that book? Or is it just that that's the part where most customers go through naturally when they walk into the store? You're like, this sounds nice and pretty and fun, but it's probably a lot of work, which it is, but do they make money? And so I knew that if I was, I've been consulting for 14 years in retail, and I knew if I went to pitch someone on a store that changes every 4 to 8 weeks with inventory and all this stuff, that I'd be short of a one-way ticket to an insane asylum. But what you can't argue with is black and white numbers. And in retail, here's a fact. In year three, you break even. In year three, you're on your way to being profitable. About 50% of those businesses are profitable, but the industry average and standard is break even in year three. So I thought if I want people to take me seriously and wait to have those conversations, I want it to be profitable in 1 year. And I'm glad to say we were.